All right, I arrived here at Tonto National Monument. I am going to go seek out the upper cliff dwelling at this point. Got here early, not too many people yet, and I'm really excited about this. You can see the trail to this starts over this way. Looks like there's a small line of people congregated over here. Look at all those beautiful wildflowers. I was here a couple weeks ago, and they look like they're even more vibrant. I see a lot more purple this time. Starting the journey up to the upper ruins now. They just let us in. It's 9 a.m. Those flowers are really in bloom right now. So this is a very rare opportunity. Usually they don't let people walk up here unguided. You, as I think I've mentioned before, you normally have to make a reservation and go as part of a guided tour, which they only do once a day on certain days. So I was really sad to find out when I came here a couple weeks ago to tour the lower ruins that reservations were booked, but then the ranger told me about today. Wow, it is really significantly cooler down here by the creek in the shade. I'm starting to see the charred remains of trees from a fire they had here last year. I think it was called the Woodbury Fire. It's really crazy to see how close the fire got to Tonto National Monument right back there. Crossing this wash on the trail. So you can clearly see, if you want to visit in the future and go as part of a guided tour, it's certainly not an accessible trail. I'm trying to deduce where we're going. I see cave-like structures up there, up on the cliffs. I don't know if we're going to that height. You can see more people scaling that hill over there. So things are about to get a little real, I think. And some more evidence of that fire I mentioned earlier, the Woodbury Fire. I see the dwellings actually right up there. So that is our destination, I believe. So if you're thinking of doing this as part of a tour and are curious about the level of difficulty, I would not rate this as difficult at all. The trail is pretty rocky, but it really does switch back nicely. The ascent hasn't been that steep. It's been a gradual ascent, winding back and forth up the mountain so far. Old dwellings or not, the scene back here is worth it on its own. I can't stop taking pictures around here. I knew there'd be wildflowers out here, and I was here a couple weeks ago and these were already blooming, but they just really opened up. Oh, wow. There it is. Just feet away. Mm-hmm. So just as with the lower ruins, these here behind me are approximately 700 years old. Looks like you can climb these stairs here. All right, one of the best part about this is being able to go inside. So I was just inquiring about this. This is a cistern that they built. There used to be a natural seepage of water that would come through here and flow, and they would collect water here. Yeah, this is really amazing. If you ever get a chance to come check this out, this is something else. So I have had a chance to ask several questions of some of the volunteers and rangers over here. And I found out that, yeah, when you see wood in here, it's almost certainly original wood. Probably 700 years old easily. A lot of the masonry and the mud that you see is original. I was told that the lower ruin is about 80% original, and the people here said this one's probably about the same, if not more so. Now there is some reconstruction and preservation that they've had to do over the years to keep this standing, but yeah, this really gives you a very rare opportunity to go inside of something that's very much as it was 700 years ago. This room looks pretty neat. Look at that. It's unfortunate you can see graffiti. And I was told this is actually a door here, T-shaped door, not a window. So they could have entered here. You can actually see wood below here too. So yeah, I did confirm that all of this is original. All of the wood, all of the masonry, all of the mud here on the wall. So I did inquire about these posts that have numbers in them, and these are where they took core samples of the wood so they could do dating. And here's another spot where they took a core sample of the wood to date it. So that's how they know that this stuff is probably 700 plus years old. That was absolutely amazing. So here's a good place to survey the trail in case you're curious. You can see folks walking around that way, and it's gonna wind down the hill down there all the way back down through that wash to the visitor center. Okay, so some really helpful information to know. I did inquire with the ranger back there, is this an annual event? The self-guided, no reservation required, walk up to the upper ruins. And yes, she did say it's an annual event. So if you missed this year, keep your sights on next year, probably around early March, I assume. Second thing I was curious about, this bloom that's happening here with these poppies. I asked her, is it a coincidence that they schedule this on this date to coincide with the blooms? And it kind of actually is somewhat of a coincidence. That bloom is not guaranteed. In some years, you don't get that. They did get it this year, probably because they had enough rain, but also they had a fire in this area last summer, the Woodbury fire. And this is just everything kind of recovering now and really promoting new growth. So I really lucked out, I think, to have the beautiful flowers, mind-blowingly beautiful, and be able to go up to the ruin on a self-guided tour. This was an awesome day. If you enjoyed this adventure today, please like, share, and subscribe. And be sure to look us up on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas.
Mind blown.